Before we start this video, I want you to take a look at your left hand. Where do you think it came from? It didn't just appear, because like everything else, it came from somewhere. It was built bit by bit. That's right, we are made of itty-bitty microscopic building blocks called atoms. Now take a look at your right hand. Do you think that it came from the same origin as your left hand? Or the same building blocks? Well, what if I told you that there is a chance that your right hand comes from a completely different origin than your left hand? No, I know what you're thinking. Don't worry, it all makes sense at the end.
Let's put our rings on.
I don't want it, it's bad luck.
I don't believe in luck. I do believe we've known each other since forever, though.
Really?
Yeah.
This clip is from the 2014 movie, UVI Origins. This particular scene may not be familiar to you, but as you'll hear in this video, it is a surprisingly good representation of our topic. And sure enough, you'll understand why Ian believes that they've known each other since forever. So, in talking about hands, we want to ask the question, is it possible that the atoms in your hands came from different origins? And how is that possible? In order to answer this question, we have to look at the bigger picture. And don't worry, we don't mean your whole body or even your parents' bodies. To understand how we came to be, we have to understand how we came to exist at all. That is, how the universe came to exist and where it came from. The questions about the origins of the universe have puzzled us for hundreds of years. That infinite darkness can seem overwhelming and without shape or form. Just a dark void peppered with the ultra-hot burning ball of gas, or the sun as we call it. And the farthest we can even look into this void doesn't even represent a fraction of its totality. If we just talk about the Milky Way galaxy, there are a billion of these suns neither too close nor too far away from our sun. But can we really answer where it all came from? Well, scientists are certainly trying. With the help of modern technologies and centuries of observations, the most convincing theory for the origin of the universe is the Big Bang theory. It states that the universe began some 13.8 billion years ago with an explosion from an extremely dense and hot point called the Big Bang singularity. Energy from the Big Bang created an equal amount of particles called matter and antimatter particles. They are produced in pairs when they come in contact as they leave pure energy behind. This energy created quarks, the building blocks of protons and neutrons. As time passed, the universe was cool enough for protons and neutrons to be stable, but hot enough for them to fuse. This fusion then produced lots and lots of hydrogen and helium nuclei, and the era is called the Big Bang nucleosynthesis. This cooling also enabled the electrons to combine with nuclei and form the first atoms. Now, the universe has grown to 600 light years, and the hydrogen and helium nuclei have begun to collect and form gas clouds. Recent observations suggest that after 150 to 200 million years after the Big Bang, these clouds of hydrogen and helium clump together to form a huge ball of gas. The high temperature and pressure initiated nuclear reactions in the core of these gas balls, and then the first stars were born. The universe was glowing with the spectacular explosions. Because stars exert an immense amount of gravity, they started collecting in denser regions. This resulted in the formation of galaxies. Observations suggest that galaxy formation started just 1 billion years after the Big Bang. So far, we have seen how hydrogen and helium, the first stars, and the first galaxies were formed. Now, that's all well and good, but what does that really mean? Is everything just made out of hydrogen and helium? What about your house, your car, or even the air that you breathe? Are those just different variations of hydrogen and helium? And where did these heavier elements like iron, carbon, and oxygen come from? Well, the answer lies in the stars. Stars, by accidents, are giant factories. Most of the mass of a newly born star is composed of hydrogen. This hydrogen fuses to form helium, and since helium is a heavier gas than hydrogen, it then moves inward. Due to very high temperature and pressure, helium then fuses and forms heavier elements. In this way, heavier and heavier elements such as carbon, nitrogen, and oxygen are formed. At some point, a star will have used all hydrogen. At this stage, the outer layers of the star will expand, becoming something known as a red giant. It is estimated that when our sun becomes a red giant, in about 5.4 billion years from now, it will swallow Mercury, Venus, and possibly Earth. Now, at this point, you might be asking, but what about iron or gold? Where did those elements come from? Well, it's much of the same process. We start with hydrogen, which is concentrated around the core by this point, and then begin to heat up and get smaller as it fuses into helium. Those helium atoms fuse in different numbers to create other elements. Stars can vary in size, and only massive stars are able to produce heavier elements. These massive stars exert tremendous gravity, which increases their temperature and pressure. This would then increase the process of fusion to produce heavier elements of the periodic table. But what happens when stars run out of hydrogen? Now, how is everything made if everything starts from hydrogen? Well, not everything is. And once a star runs out of hydrogen, it begins to use heavier elements to create new elements. For example, if you were to fuse helium and neon, you would get magnesium and oxygen, different elements with non-hydrogen bases. And the more massive the star is, the heavier the elements that it produces. Deep in the core of these stars, these fusions can create elements as heavy as iron. Once iron is formed, there aren't many fusion possibilities left. In fact, there are really none. So what does a star do then? As the fusion reaction stops, the star explodes into a supernova. This explosion releases an incredible amount of neutrons for the iron to capture, which then turns that iron into heavier elements like gold, uranium, and platinum. Everything that exists today is made up of elements, elements that share their past with the stars. Everything that we have and everything that we are started as a star. Who knows where you might have been from, where your left hand started or your right. They could have been millions of light years away from each other, but somehow they ended up as a part of you, just a few feet apart at most. Some might call that fate or luck, but is it really so far-fetched to believe that some of your atoms came from the same space as someone else's?
When the Big Bang happened, all the atoms in the universe, they were all smashed together into one little dot that exploded outward. So my atoms and your atoms were certainly together then, and who knows, probably smashed together several times in the last 13.7 billion years. So my atoms have known your atoms, and they've always known your atoms. My atoms have always loved your atoms.
Thank you for watching this video. I'm Harry, and I'm so glad you made it to the end. If you like this type of content, please subscribe. If you want to, follow us on Instagram @BeyondIdeas. I'll see you again next week for more curiosity videos. Bye-bye.